to know, because you are mentioning that you are providing ready to cook, right? You are providing the ingredient. So perhaps nowadays, do you think this is workable? Because now people like to eat, love to eat, doesn't mean they love to cook. Okay, so this is number point one. Number two, can I know, because they are more selling on the, you are selling part, right? And you are providing the ingredient, am I right? So you are providing the ingredient, and how do you control or manage the food safety? This is question number one, please. Can you please explain?
Thank you for your questions. To answer your question one, apparently we have done a survey in Bukit Bintang, and the survey have gave us a result that actually there's more because Bukit Bintang have a lot of students from Berjaya, and from the data that we have collected, we actually found out that there's more people who are enjoying the process of cooking more than taste the food outside, like they homemade it themselves, then actually they are more feel like proud of that. And move on to the second question about food safety. For your information, food safety, a temperature for danger zone to have the bacteria to grow is actually from 4 degrees Celsius to 66. So for our ingredients, we will have raw ingredients which we will froze it before the day, so that we will make sure that the ingredients are in safe temperature, which is below 4. And when we are delivering it, we will make sure that our product is in cooler bag so that the temperature is not going to increase or decrease too much. Thank you.
By the way, another question is because you are talking about this ingredient, so you will have a sort of a lot of raw materials to keep and frozen and so on, right? So what is your pricing setup compared to the ready food? You know, you need to compare to the restaurant and so on. How do you measure or set up the pricing? Because it is very competitive industry.
So basically, we will, because we need to have the kitchen, same as others restaurant, because we need the kitchens to prepare those food and the chillers to keep those ingredients. So I think the cost is almost the same, just that we're slightly lower because the food is not really cooked yet. Yeah.
All right, so next up, may I ask TSP Hsiong, do you have any question?
Hi, I would like to know what is the cost to the consumer who are engaging this service to get the food ready? What's the cost? What will be the cost for this person?
Selling price.
How much? Price.
Thank you for your question.
Yeah.
For your information, the cost will be depending on different menu. For example, as I mentioned before, we have salted egg chicken in our menu, which only costs 12 ringgit per meal.
All
right. How do you compare with this solution because it's a food processor? You know, there's a food processor. Yes, the ratio is very high, about 6,000 or something like that. Like that, then you just put in the ingredient, press the button, and it will come out. Easy.
In order to compare us, different us with other factory and all those restaurants, we're actually providing them ingredients which is raw, which so that, as I mentioned before, that the power of transparency. People start to concern about what are exactly in their food. So if we providing them raw ingredients, and they will know exactly what's inside their food so that it's healthy, and also the season is done by themselves so that they can adjust it and without any MSG or chemical concerns.
I think we... All right, so one more question for Porfora. Do you have any questions?
Did you mention just now that we have existing customers? Is how many of them? How many?
Currently, we have received around 20 orders.
20 orders, but have you started?
Yes, we have
received. So what is their feedback about your services?
Sorry?
What is their experience of your services?
Yes, they actually enjoy in cooking. Because most of our customers, they actually love cooking, but they don't know how to cook. So we, by providing those recipes, they actually will take photos and tag us in the Instagram. So this will help us to promote our business as well.
Okay, but I seriously still cannot gauge, you know, how different are you from those, those people who share on YouTube on how to cook and things like that. So maybe perhaps that is one thing that you want to, polish. And another thing is about the market. Because you're talking about just particularly in a city center, you did not share with us on which particular market that you want to focus on. So maybe that's another area that you want to focus on and work on and improve.
Alright, thank you, Fanhara. And once again, thank you so much for Greek Cues, and thank you so much for the panel. Alright, right now, we will be